Hello students, welcome to the lecture on sports environment, and after this lecture we will be able to learn the following objectives: explain the meaning and need for sports environment, discuss the role of media for creating positive sports environment, define the role of individual in improvement of sports environment, discuss the prevention of sports related accidents, explain the role of spectators for creating positive sports environment, define the essential elements of positive sports environment. Let's start with discussion on sports. In our society, sport fulfills important functions and is indeed indispensable. It offers opportunities for physical activity in a world where physical activity is increasingly diminishing. It promotes good health and well-being, and it provides a means of social contact and ample opportunity for intensive experiences. Sport as recreational and physical education activities is nowadays a major component of society. It gathers under its umbrella millions of adepts worldwide and constitutes through its clubs, associations and other organizations a major and well-structured network in our society. Sports help children develop physical skills, get exercise, make friends, have fun, learn to play as a member of a team, learn to play fair, and improve self-esteem. A very large number of people engage in sport or exercise for the benefits of health-related fitness, with a major rise in recent years of jogging and aerobics. Sport is part of our social and cultural fabric, possessing a social and commercial power that makes it a potent force in the world for good and for bad. It takes a lot of dedication and hard work to become an athlete in whichever sport we choose.
Playing sports and how they impact you. Just as a library is necessary for the mental health of a person, so is a playground for the physical health. Playing sports, indoor or outdoor, is important for the mental as well as physical development of an individual, and every sport has its own unique advantages. Let's look at a few sports and how they impact us. 1. Cricket. There are many benefits on playing cricket. Cricket helps in enhancing hand-eye coordination. When you play cricket, you get fit by running between wickets, running up to ball, and running after the ball to field it. When you play cricket, you will develop stamina because cricket games can last for a very long time. 2. Football. Football players require a great level of stamina. Among various factors, concentration is the most important thing. Even a tiny distraction can make you lose the game. Thus, players can increase their concentration spans with this game. Further, football works very well to develop your leg muscles, namely the shins and thighs. Legs, being the largest muscles of the body, are the most crucial. They enhance muscle growth across the body by releasing testosterone and growth hormones. 3. Hockey. Hockey is a fast-paced sport that improves its player's pace, agility, and lower body strength. Playing hockey is a fun and effective way of burning off calories, with its fast pace requiring short bursts of sprint energy, along with long-term stamina over the course of a match. The sustained energy and holistic muscular strength required in a hockey match help develop the body's cardiovascular system, therefore improve your breathing by pumping more oxygen around the body. Hockey is one sport that works on both your legs as well as upper body at the same time. Playing hockey is a great way of developing your body's leg muscles, including the hamstring, hips, and calves. It also improves the endurance of shoulder muscles, triceps, and forearms. Hockey relies on good coordination between the eyes and the hands and improves the reflexes and reaction times of its players. 4. Swimming. Swimming works your whole body, improving cardiovascular conditioning, muscle strength, endurance, posture, and flexibility all at the same time. Your cardiovascular system in particular benefits because swimming improves your body's use of oxygen without overworking your heart. As you become fitter and are able to swim longer, your resting heart rate and respiratory rate will be reduced, making blood flow to the heart and lungs more efficient. If you're looking to lose weight, swimming is just the ticket. Chess. Chess is now known to be an imaginative and strategic game. People find playing chess relaxing, and it also helps them to think analytically. It improves the focus and concentration of one's mind. Chess teaches a person to analyze different situations and think 1,000 times before taking a step, as not always the first decision is the right one. As chess requires one to remember various positions and strategies, this helps in improved memory and increased concentration. Sports are the most natural way to stay fit, since playing a sport never seems like an effort, but only seems fun.
Now answer this question. Sport is part of our social and cultural fabric, possessing a social and commercial power that makes it a potent force in the world for good and for bad. True? False? Answer is true. Meaning and need for sports environment. Sport has been defined by a UNESCO committee as any physical activity which has the character of play and which involves a struggle with oneself or with others or a confrontation with natural elements. They added, if this activity involves competition, it must then always be performed in a spirit of sportsmanship. There can be no true sports without the idea of fair play. Sports do not only keep us in shape, but they also make us a better person. It might not make sense, but this is true. Those of us who want to stay in shape and other things, sports needs to be there for us. Some things that team sports teach that go well beyond scoring, batting, shooting, and winning. Ego checks. Any parent knows that a child can be extremely egocentric, but that my way or the highway attitude will have to stay in check on a team sport. Positive mentors. A dedicated, thoughtful, and skilled coach can have an amazing impact on children. In fact, sometimes a child will respond better to an objective coach than they will to their own parent. The three P's. Kids need to learn that being part of a sport teams requires the three P's: practice, patience, and persistence. Another reason for family time. Playing catch in the yard, heading down to the local soccer field for some drill practice. These types of outings with kids can mean a great deal in busy parenting culture. Team sports help the man to become socially interactive. It helps to construct better friendships. Types of sports. Sport types generally fall into four main categories: racing, human-powered, running, swimming, human-assisted, cycling, rowing, canoeing, animal, horse racing, greyhound racing, pigeon racing, machine-powered, auto racing, motorboat racing, motorcycle racing. Opponent, combat, wrestling, judo, karate, boxing, fencing, taekwondo. Court, tennis, badminton, shuttlecock, squash, volleyball, table tennis, American handball. Team, baseball, cricket, football, soccer, rugby, ice hockey, roller hockey, hockey, softball, basketball, lacrosse, American football, Australian rules football, competitive cheerleading. Achievement. Target. Archery, shooting, darts, curling. Display. Gymnastics, bodybuilding, diving, sky jumping, ice skating, equestrianism, strength, weightlifting, distance, long jump, high jump, triple jump, pole vault, shot put, javelin, hammer throw. Multidiscipline: heptathlon, decathlon, pentathlon, triathlon, biathlon, Ironman. Multiple category sports: paintball. Now let's discuss the essential elements of positive sports environment. The playground provides possibilities to engage in any and all play types. It is a rich interplay between children and the play environment that is important, not whether children engage in this or that play type. The child's eye view of what is special has precedence, and the playground is concreted with the children. The outdoor play area should offer, as far as possible, a variety of playable spaces, including challenging play structures and features, quiet chill-out areas, wild nature and planted areas, water and sand play, informal sports areas, fully accessible play equipment. Research tells us that the uncertainty and challenge of much of children's play is a very large part of its appeal to them, but also that it enhances the development of their brains and bodies, making them more adaptable and resilient as they grow. All one needs to win in any sport is a desire to win, fitness, endurance, and persistence. Individual in improvement of sports environment. The following role of individual in improvement of sports environment: be happy, have fun participating in sport, and have a passion for doing what one is doing. Quiet in the mind. Having a quiet mind lets us all make the best decisions, and it helps us to be centered. Have a plan. Set goals for the big picture and smaller process goals that lay out steps to help get to big picture goal. Commit. Commit to the plan. Commit to goals and know what one wants. Self-talk. One must be own cheerleader. Sure, surround oneself with like-minded, positive and supportive individuals. Studies have shown that this will increase our chances of success. Prevention of sports-related accidents. One all want to keep our children safe and secure and help them live to their full potential. Knowing how to prevent injuries from sports and recreation activities, one of the leading causes of child injury, is a step towards this goal. Types of injuries. In general, one can say that sports and exercise injuries fall into two categories: overuse injuries and traumatic injuries. Overuse injuries occur when one overstresses the tissues and do not allow enough time for recovery. Common overuse injuries include muscle strains, knee pain, tendinopathy, shin splints, tight calves, sore heels. The most common symptom of an overuse injury is pain, but one may also experience tingling, numbness, swelling, stiffness or weakness in the affected area. Traumatic injuries. Traumatic injuries come on suddenly and will result in immediate pain and signs of tissue damage such as bruising, swelling and loss of function. They are often the result of contact during sport and can happen whether or not we have a careful warm-up. Common traumatic injuries include bruising or cuts, sprains, example ankle sprain, wrist sprain, fractures or broken bones, dislocations when a joint pops out, Common symptoms of acute injuries include sudden severe pain, swelling, restricted movement, and extreme weakness. There may also be obvious signs of a dislocation or a broken bone. Prevention. Gear up. When children are active in sports and recreation, make sure they use the right protective gear for their activity, such as helmets, wrist guards, knee or elbow pads. Use the right stuff. Be sure that sports protective equipment is in good condition and worn correctly all the time. Practice makes perfect. Have children learn and practice skills they need in their activity. Pay attention to temperature. Allow time for child athletes to gradually adjust to hot or humid environments to prevent heat-related injuries or illness. Be a good model. Communicate positive safety messages and serve as a model of safe behavior, including wearing a helmet and following the rules. Wear appropriate protective gear and equipment. Protective pads, mouth guards, helmets, gloves, and other equipment are not for sissies. Always warm up before playing. Warm muscles are less susceptible to injuries. The proper warm-up is essential for injury prevention. Make sure warm-up suits sport. In addition to that, one needs to pay attention to the warning signs that body provides. Athletes with high consecutive days of training have more injuries, and many of them have a misconception of more pain, more gain. Some soreness is common after exercising, but if it continues, one is pushing too hard. Soreness is caused by inflammation and micro tears in the muscle fibers. The proper amount of rest will differ among different individuals. Women generally require more recovery time than men, as do older individuals compared to younger ones. One must know this. Rest. Reduce or stop using the injured area for at least 48 hours. Ice. Put an ice pack on the injured area for 20 minutes at a time, 4 to 8 times per day. Compression. Ask doctor about elastic wraps, air casts, special boots or splints that can be used to compress an injured ankle, knee or wrist to reduce swelling. Elevation. Keep the injured area elevated above the level of the heart to help decrease swelling. Preventions for the injuries. Safer sports equipment. For some sports, injuries can be prevented by making sporting equipment safer. The use of protective equipment. For certain sports, the use of protective equipment can reduce the risks of experiencing an injury. These are designed either to protect against direct blows to the body or to support or protect muscles and joints while a person is active. These include helmets, face guards, eye goggles, knee, wrist and ankle braces or supports, knee or elbow pads, mouth guards, specialized footwear, and cushioned insoles. Since the risks of injury vary from sport to sport, the effectiveness of protective equipment depends to a large extent on the sport being played. Equipment that is effective during one sport may not offer protection during another. Now, before moving on to the next topic, just answer the following question. Dash come on suddenly and will result in immediate pain and signs of tissue damage such as bruising, swelling, and loss of function. Overuse injuries, traumatic injuries, gear up, none of these. Answer B. Traumatic injuries. Role of spectators for creating positive sports environment. Now moving on to our next topic. A spectator is somebody that watches something. The players are motivated by enthusiasm of the watchers. Spectators are a very significant element to fulfill a successful competition in sports. Spectators in sport are often an identity and sometimes novelty within themselves. For viewers of any standing, fellow spectators can often make, break, sweeten or sour a sporting experience. Spectators are for sporting organizations what customers are for many commercial companies. To ensure that spectators at events are treated equally and fairly, and that the spectator experience provide good quality for money, it might be useful for many sporting organizations and associations to formulate a customer spectator charter. A customer spectator charter should be shared among all employees and volunteers, and it will explain the different areas where customers spectators can expect service and who is responsible for providing the service. Parents are most visibly supportive in their role as spectators on the sidelines for youth sports. Of course, parents are excited and want to see their child play. However, it is important that they keep their emotions under control and set a positive example. Here are some things for parents to remember. Applaud and cheer for everyone on the team, not just our child. Avoid insulting other team members and those of the opposing team. Talk to the parents of the other team members. Be respectful of the officials during the game. After the game, thank the officials. Focus on the positive and compliment players, coaches and officials. Be positive and congratulate the winning team. Do not forget to congratulate the losing team on their efforts. Role of media for creating positive sports environment. Mass media consists of the various means by which information reaches large numbers of people, such as television, radio, movies, newspapers, and the internet. The impact of media upon sport is substantial and varied, from alterations made to the equipment, match times, venues, to financial changes which impact on all levels of sport. Media has always had a massive effect on sports, but with the increasing importance of media in all walks of life, its impact on sport is increasing proportionally. Both television and sports have grown rich and influential as a result of their partnership. Sports and the media have coexisted since the advent of newspapers onto radio and through into television. The media have come to play a significant role in the constant reformulation of the term sport. The every sense of the meaning of the category sport has been shaped by the emergence of the sporting press and television sport. The media can determine what or who we watch. It can alter our perception of a player or team. The media's level of influence upon sport is unimaginable. What are the different types of media? There are four types of media. Newspapers. A publication that appears regularly and frequently carries news about a wide variety of current events. Magazines. Magazines generally offer more comprehensive, in-depth coverage of a subject than newspapers. Many magazines have editorial calendars which provide information about special issues or features planned for the year. Radio. Radio is a wireless transmission through space of electromagnetic waves in the approximate frequency range from 10 kHz to 3 lakh MHz. Television. Television is the transmission of visual images of moving and stationary objects, generally with accompanying sound as electromagnetic waves and the reconversion of received waves into visual images. Mass media means reaching a large audience using different kinds of communication methods. Examples of mass media are magazines, newspapers, radio, television, but also recently internet has established big expansion, so it is also considered as mass media. Mass media has many different purposes, such as providing information, entertaining, persuading, and also by carrying a vague general function of culture to millions of people. In order for mass media to exist, there must be an audience. Today's society is very selective. Each receiver reacts differently through his or her own experience and orientation. Therefore, mass media exists in many different forms, such as magazines, television, newspapers, internet, motion pictures, and even plays. Positive effects of the media in sports. The media has given the sport exposure to a much larger audience than just the people in attendance at the games. This means people who like to watch the sport but cannot afford to go to the games live can watch it in their home or listen or read the result of the game in newspapers or on the internet, which is also an extension of the media. Media attention on the sport has created such a financial market for the sport. Universities and high schools have basketball programs which give children who excel in the sport and cannot afford post-secondary education a chance to attend university and a possible career in the sport. Basketball's growth on a financial aspect is a direct result of the media. In the past, the salaries of athletes in the professional league are non-comparative with the salaries of the athletes today because the media provides a larger audience which provides revenue to teams and players get a share of this new wealth. Basketball players are now seen as role models through the media and people try imitating their basketball heroes to the extent players with charismatic personalities and excellent basketball skills are paid to endorse products. The media has expanded the women's equality struggles into the sport of basketball by giving women exposure in the sport as actual athletes and not their traditional roles. Women were thought of as the cheerleaders of the sport. The media coverage of sport has good effects. Money. Media companies pay for the rights to show a sporting event. Also, sports shown on the TV generate more sponsorship. Education. People learn the rules of the sport from watching it on TV and also get entertained. Role models. Seeing good sports people on TV and in newspapers makes them a role model for people to look up. Inspiration. Media brings sport to people who may not normally get to experience it otherwise. This can encourage people to get involved. As it gives regular updates, it gives consistent inspiration. Coaching aid. Watching professionals on the TV can help us see how a technique should be performed, which could help our performance. Promotes and popularizes traditional and new sports. Generates finance. Example, sponsorship, which could be used for junior development. Informs, enlightens, and instructs. Technological innovations have resulted in better coverage, analysis, and statistics. Raising awareness and interest, which results in greater participation. Create star performers who hopefully become role models. Ever-increasing audiences worldwide result in increased sponsorship. Now answer the following questions. Magazines generally offer more comprehensive, in-depth coverage of a subject than newspapers. True? False? Answer: true. Television increased the influence upon sport because of its accessibility to the A. media population, B. mass population, C. both A and B, D. none of these. Answer: C. both. Now in the end, let us summarize what we have learnt in this lecture. Sports help children develop physical skills, get exercise, make friends, have fun, learn to play as a member of a team, learn to play fair, and improve self-esteem. Sport is part of our social and cultural fabric, possessing a social and commercial power that makes it a potent force in the world for good and for bad. Sports. Any physical activity which has the character of play and which involves a struggle with oneself or with others or a confrontation with natural elements. The outdoor play area should offer, as far as possible, a variety of playable spaces. The three P's: practice, patience, and persistence. Sports and exercise injuries fall into two categories: overuse injuries and traumatic injuries. One needs to pay attention to the warning signs that body provides. A spectator is somebody that watches something. Mass media consists of the various means by which information reaches large numbers of people, such as television, radio, movies, newspapers, and the internet.